Baltimore?
We are from Baltimore.
I'm a city councilman in the district.
You're a city councilman. What is it? If you're watching this, tell me what this means for your city.
Cease fire.
When you're watching this go on, does it break your heart to see this happen?
Oh, definitely. I mean, what it is young boys, the young folks of the community showing decades old of anger, frustration for a system that's failed them. I mean, this is bigger than Freddie Gray. This is about the socioeconomics of poor urban America. And, you know, these young guys are frustrated, they're upset, and unfortunately, they're displaying it in a very destructive manner. You know, when folks are undereducated, unfortunately, they don't have the same intellectual voice to express it the way other people do, and that's what we see through the violence today.
We just watched this liquor store being looted, and there's a bunch of folks running in and out of there.
Yeah. Nothing doing nothing.
What's wrong with that? The police are all the way down there. You're a city council member, is that right?
Is it right for people to loot? No, I mean, I think you've missed everything I've tried to articulate to you. What I've said is everything out here has happened wrong. The violence is wrong. That's never acceptable. Understanding that there's a symptom of something that's going on here, and what I'm trying to articulate to you is we look at communities like this in urban America, lack of education, lack of commercial development, lack of opportunities. It's the socioeconomics of it. It has nothing to do with West Baltimore or this particular corner in Baltimore. This could erupt anywhere in socially, economically deprived America.
Well, we've certainly seen this in other cities. Obviously, Ferguson comes to mind.
We also see it at rallies like at Kentucky. When Kentucky lost that basketball game, we see crowds that loot and that flip over cars and stuff. But unfortunately, you know, all of the 95% of the positive rallying that has been occurring here in Baltimore, the national media is going to focus on this. And that's the problem.
So what are the legitimate grievances in your mind that folks have about being here? Is it against the police? Is it against the poverty?
This is a culmination of a lot of different things. You know, decades old of failed policies. You know, decades old of lack of development for these communities. I mean, it's a lot that pours into it, and these young boys are speaking tonight, unfortunately, in a very wrong way.
Do you have any idea why, as we're seeing what's going on here, and obviously you've got the police who have now backed off, any idea why?
We asked them to back off. The men of this community came together. We talked to the police. We told them we would be able to kind of talk to the young guys out here, and we asked them to back up, and they did it. It worked out.
It worked out, but the liquor store's still being looted.
That was best pass. And at this point, this is not productive.
Go ahead, Megan.
Ask one of these guys, please. We've seen allegations that even though he says